is a Trump project to keep Stormy Daniels quiet. I don't know. I mean, obviously, I never spoke to Stormy Daniels. You all have. I don't know the underlying truth here of what went on between Donald Trump and Stormy Daniels, if anything. But what's quite clear is that not just Michael Cohen, but the Trump organization is trying to keep her quiet.
And let me add this, Anderson. I think Jeff raises a very good point relating to the date of this document, February 22nd, 2018. The statement that you placed before your viewers earlier from Mr. Cohen predated this statement, not postdated it.
So he had already gone on record saying that this was not a Trump organization operation.
Exactly. Weeks prior, when he went on record, it was weeks prior to February 22nd, 2018. And weeks later, Jill Martin, a vice president and general counsel of the organization, signs this document.
Let me put up that Michael Cohen statement again, just for our viewers. Okay, so this is Michael Cohen before...
it has the date.
Yeah, February, what is that, 14th? 13th. In a private transaction in 2016, I used my own personal funds to facilitate a payment of $130,000 to Ms. Stephanie Clifford. Neither the Trump organization, and then it continues, nor the Trump campaign was a party to the transaction with Ms. Clifford, and neither reimbursed me for the payment either directly or indirectly. So the whole notion that the Trump organization was not a party to, whether it's to that or to this ongoing operation, certainly to the ongoing operation, you can't say the Trump organization is not a party.
Not involved. Now, what I assume Jill Martin would say is I wasn't really involved in the litigation. She uses the phrase pro hoc, which refers to the act of allowing an out-of-town lawyer to appear in your state. That she will say, and that's implied in her statement, is that, well, I wasn't really involved in the litigation. I was just helping Mr. Rosen, the real lawyer, appear here because he's not a California lawyer. But that goes to the question of, out of all the lawyers in California to help you get your point across, why do you pick someone in the Trump organization unless this is a Trump organization initiative?
I suppose Mr. Cohen could also say, and again, we reach out to him, have not heard back, that because he wanted this to remain confidential, that's why he reached out to somebody in the Trump organization. Would that make sense?
Well, no, it wouldn't, because there's something called the attorney-client privilege, which mandates that attorneys that are licensed, that are serving clients, maintain the confidences of those clients. So the idea that somehow this was the only attorney in the entire state of California that would maintain this confidence, I think is nonsense.
So it would be the last person you would involve is someone from the Trump organization if you were trying to wall this off from the Trump organization. You would never go to a Trump organization person. You would go to anyone but.
But I mean, Michael Cohen, as far as I know, is a trained attorney. So, I mean, why would a trained attorney make this statement in early February, mid-February, on the 13th or 14th, saying Trump organization, nothing to do with it, and then after making that statement, and it's not like it was a small statement, that was a big deal statement, got a lot of coverage, why would any licensed attorney then reach out to somebody in the Trump organization, even if it was for a minimal role?
I mean, again, to play lawyer here, I think he might say that that statement only applied to who was paying. The Trump organization didn't pay. This statement, this is not an acknowledgement that the Trump organization actually paid any money. I mean, I'm right. Trying to torture the
but
words.
They are, but it is an example, according to both of you, that the Trump organization is involved in this ongoing effort.
It certainly is.
Anderson, for all intents and purposes, every piece of actual evidence, separate apart from what Mr. Cohen may try to tell the American people, every piece of actual evidence demonstrates that EC LLC equals the Trump organization / Donald Trump. That's what the evidence shows. That's what the emails show. That's what this document shows. That's what other documents show. It's that simple. There's no distinction.
And the reason why anyone should care about, you know, who these people are is the question is who paid this hush money and why? Why did Stormy Daniels get $130,000 on the eve of the election? Michael Cohen has been saying this was just me. The Trump organization had nothing to do with it. These documents, they don't prove, but they certainly suggest that the Trump organization has been intimately involved in the effort to keep Stormy Daniels quiet from the beginning.
But you still don't know where the money came from, where the $130,000 came from. Michael Cohen says it's from his home equity line of credit.
Not yet, but thus far, when we have attempted to test the veracity of the statements of Michael Cohen, he's failed each time, and I'm highly confident that he's going to fail that one, too.
Michael Avenatti, appreciate it. Jeff Toobin as well. More to come on that, no doubt. Next, the latest on the too-close-to-call congressional race election in western Pennsylvania and White House efforts to paint a Democratic victory is actually a victory for President Trump. I'll show you how they do that. And later, waves of kids walk out of their schools in a nationwide effort to bring attention to gun violence and school safety. I'll show you where it happened and how big it was.